Influenza is a very common disease in children because every winter season, particularly in pandemic periods, up to 30% of children suffer from influenza. Influenza is not only a common disease, it's also a very severe disease, particularly in children younger than 5 years of age, because in most of the cases this disease leads to hospitalization, leads to admission to the intensive care unit, and in some cases leads to death. And we can try to solve the problem with vaccination. Vaccines against influenza are available since several years. Presently, we have two vaccines, a live attenuated vaccine and an injectable inactivated vaccine. But both the vaccines have a problem. The inactivated vaccine cannot be used in children under than 6 months of age, and the live attenuated vaccine cannot be used in children younger than 2 years of age. Practically, we have a group of children, those younger than 6 months of age, that cannot receive the vaccination and cannot be immunized, so that they can suffer from severe cases of influenza. How can we solve the problem? In this case, the solution of the problem is given by the administration of the influenza vaccine, in this case the inactivated influenza vaccine, to the mother during pregnancy. It has been demonstrated that the administration of inactivated influenza vaccine to a pregnant woman during the last 3 months of pregnancy leads to protection to the child, at least for the first 3 months after birth. And this is very important because a long period after birth is protected through the vaccination of the mother. The problem is that despite maternal vaccination is recommended by all the health authorities worldwide, practically a very low number of pregnant women receive the vaccine. Probably there are some different opinions among obstetrics and gynecologists, and in some cases among pediatricians, that are not able to suggest influenza because they think that influenza vaccine can lead to some adverse event to the mother and to the fetus, forgetting that the vaccine is useful for the mother and is useful above all for the child. We can try to convince obstetrics and pediatricians that the vaccine must be done because this is the only method to reduce the risk of severe infection in younger infants.